to do is actually take a look at your cervix. All right, is that all right? Okay, I think you're starting to dilate a little bit. Okay, can you roll back onto your back? I'm gonna leave you alone.
When Delmarine Coles Atkinson and her husband Howard decided to have a baby.
Okay, I just wanna take a look, okay?
They knew the odds were against them.
Oh, just hold my hand, squeeze my hand.
Delmarine suffers from lupus.
God.
A hereditary disease that can turn deadly, especially during childbirth.
My mom also has systemic lupus. She just passed away September the 16th of last year, and she had a lot of complications when she had me. And my concerns are, am I gonna have the same complications she had?
Oh God.
The complications my mom had were seizure, and she had to end up having an emergency C-section. And after her C-section, she had a lupus attack, which attacked her heart.
Oh God, no, stop.
For the past 2 weeks, the lupus has been flaring up.
I can't do it, no.
You can do it.
Endangering both Delmarine and her baby.
3 centimeters,
girl.
Your body makes antibodies to itself. It makes components of the blood that actually attack other organs. So it can attack your joints, it can attack your skin. And with lupus, which is one of the more common autoimmune diseases, it can attack any organ in the body.
Oh, come on now. Come on, you can do it.
Okay, here we go. All right.
48 hours ago, Delmarine checked into Mercy to be induced, despite the fact that she is only at 36 weeks.
Yes, you did.
She's completely dilated.
Okay. Oh, Jesus.
Okay, all right. You did good, okay? I think your cervix is just a little kind of closed up. You're about 3 centimeters, okay? Your cervix is all the way softened out. That's completely effaced, okay?
Almost there.
Almost there, girl.
Okay, all right.
Mercy has the lowest infant mortality rate in the state. But that is little consolation to Howard Atkinson.
You okay?
Yeah, why don't you sit down?
Right now, his wife and baby are in danger.
Okay, you're gonna get the baby out in just a minute, okay?
Delmarine has been in the hospital for 2 days and in labor for 26 hours.
We are gonna be calling the nursery staff, okay, because you do have that fever. Your temperature is 102 and the baby's heart rate's a little fast.
She is running a fever, which indicates her lupus could be flaring up. Delmarine's disease is putting her baby at risk. It is imperative that she deliver the baby now.
Just go ahead and
out. All right.
Okay, take your breath in and push down, okay? You pushing?
She's coming.
Eight, nine, ten.
Delmarine has to take a break before she can push again.
All right. Go ahead and give us a good push. Here we go.
Good job.
Nice.
Push. Oh. All right, there it is.
Oh. 426.
Did it, girl.
All right.
Good job, Delmarine.
All right, yeah. Okay,
do
we want to talk to us a little bit? Okay, here we go. All right.
Oh, yeah. Good girl.
It's all over, right? Okay. Just gonna wait for this part. You don't have to do anything.
Okay. Is her head okay?
Yeah.
She's shaking because of the way she was inside.
3 days you've only been out.
Yeah. Around.
Right.
Uh-huh. There you go.
The baby's airways are cleared. But she still needs an extra blast of oxygen.
Happy birthday, darling.
This is the first time I've ever been in the living room. I didn't even see my daughter when she was born. I was out. This is amazing. Yes.
Say happy birthday to me. Yes.
My lungs might be a little immature. She's staying fine without oxygen. She's nice and pink. But the fact that she's breathing fast, I'm going to send her to the regular nursery. She has about an hour or two, and if she doesn't resolve this by then she'll need to come to the intensive care nursery. And later. But we'll let you hold her and all before we take her on down.
How you doing?
There you go. A little bit higher with your hand. Get her neck. There you go.
You got my chin. You got mommy's chin.
She got hair shots and moves. They have a chin.
Give me a kiss, Mom.
The baby's delicate condition means she will have to be watched very closely.
Later.
Because she had temperature, they'll have to draw blood from the baby to make sure there's no infection. That's sometimes a risk for infection. So they're going to look for that in the baby, too.
Thanks.
Del Marine tries to think only positive thoughts.
To the angel belonged to my mom who just passed away. She just helped me, like, you know, everything's going to be okay.
She's doing a little flaring and retracting, so that's why we brought her down here.
Well, hopefully she will continue to breathe like she is right now. Not too fast, no nasal flaring. And after a couple of hours, they'll send her back to Mom to breastfeed.
Del Marine's baby girl is being monitored in the nursery. Del Marine was running a fever of 102 when Jalen was born, and there may be complications due to her lupus.
If she continues to show signs of respiratory distress, then we'll take her upstairs and start an IV and draw blood cultures and give her whatever kind of oxygen support she needs from there. But she seems to have settled down right well. And this is the temperature we want her at and the temperature she currently is at. And the bed will give out enough heat to bring her up. Right now she's cold, so it's going to tell me.
3 hours after giving birth, Del Marine's fever has broken, and she gets to see little Jalen again.
I was just glad to see that she was okay after they checked her out. Her heart was beating a little fast because of me having a fever. I had a high fever that I didn't know that I had. She looks like me. Yeah, I'm just happy she's here and she's healthy. That was my biggest concern with my illness, that she came out healthy. Ooh, you like attention.